Hello, 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 and welcome to another episode of Crazy Town Gaming. My name is Jonaas, I'm your host, and I'm here with
TNT Dinomight, the explosive one. Jonaas, we're the man. I'm the man on the sticks.
You are the sticky boy.
And we're playing Monster Hunter World.
Oh, the biggest world, the best world, the only world.
The Monster Hunter World. They're making a movie for this game, Jonaas.
Are you serious?
I'm that serious. Freaking Tony Jaa's in it, dude.
I know who's going to be there opening night.
I will be.
I know.
Honestly, I heard. Look, man, I don't like to spread misinformation.
Yeah.
So I want to disclaim is that I heard that a stunt actor was hurt on set of the movie.
Yeah.
And because of the way her contract was set up,
right,
the movie studio was not liable for her injuries. Thus, they did not compensate her for her injuries.
Oh my god, why would you do that as a stunt woman? Like, that's the whole thing.
Yeah, but she like lost the arm and stuff.
Oh my god.
Yeah,
that's like her rest of her life is ruined.
Well,
not
yeah,
ruined, but
so,
different.
So a lot of people are actually like talking,
started GoFundMe for her.
I'm sure there has been, but a lot of people are, because like the Monster Hunter community, like, this is not the first Monster Hunter. This game has been going on since, like, the
90s. Oh, my God. There's, like, a lot of people in this game.
Yeah.
Mila Jovovich.
Yeah,
Tony
dude.
Freaking Ron Perlman.
You thought I was kidding? It's a real movie.
T.I.'s in it?
T. Fucking.
Fuck. Right? Clyde, you
what
so
is T.I. in the Monster
Hunter? So off guard, you had to drop a.
What? T.I. in the Monster Hunter movie, dude.
I don't know. Let me see what he plays.
What is he doing, dude?
I don't know. I'm going to look him up real quick.
He's on the monster.
Yeah, he's probably going to jail.
Wait, what?
Did he go to jail for something?
You're not going to highlight that, Jonaas. He serves his
sentence. He served his time. He's out.
Exactly.
But what is he? They don't have
a broken. Yeah, there's some screen. There's some screen shots.
Well, I was trying to look up to see about this lady who.
Every
Morbius, Venom 2, Artemis Fowl, the Witches.
Oh yeah, man. There's characters, you know. It's like Monster Hunter's the whole thing. Please don't hit me. You hit me. I can't believe T.I. is in it. That's actually great, man. That just sealed the deal for that movie, honestly.
Oh, wow. Resident Evil stunt woman fell abandoned by producer after he was gone.
Yeah. And like, I'm definitely not going to advocate for it. Like, if somebody gets hurt to that degree on the job, regardless of how...
What your contract says, like,
yeah, you think that the company would feel obligated, but I guess they're not.
Like, it's one thing if she like broke her arm, like, oh, that sucks. It's another, she loses her arm.
Yeah, I guess the real, this is absolute hell. I guess the real issue is like, they're probably like, was it actually her fault that she lost her arm? And I don't know if it was, and I'm not gonna say
like
if it was.
Like a, if it was like an error of the set, or if it was like her incompetence. One or two.
I'm not going to use the term incompetence, but yes, it could have been that.
Her error.
Yes, if it was in her error.
I guess that makes a difference.
But, yeah, I don't know, man. Help her out. Find the lady on GoFundMe, man, and help her out, because that, it sucks. But, I mean, honestly, she's a stunt woman.
I mean, that's part of the risk of the job, man.
No, I was going to say, if you think about it, I mean, it's kind of like a it's... God, I don't want to say look at the bright side, but a one-armed stunt woman, that's going to get you some jobs.
It is not.
It absolutely is.
It will
is.
Not, because you're a stunt woman for a person with two arms.
What?
How are they going to show?
What? Jonaas, look.
You're a stunt double. You have to look like the person that you're.
No, Jonaas, listen. I was talking to a lady who worked in the film industry. She said that amputees are big business right now, especially with like scenes where like you want to have realistic people having their limbs ripped off or something like that.
Or they can put a fake arm connected to your, like, to where your arm's amputated, and they can, like, rip it off and it, like...
I'm not expecting this lady to, like, perform martial arts and look exactly like Bruce Lee. I'm expecting her to, in this one camera shot...
get maimed on film.
I mean, essentially.
Yeah.
So, I mean, yes... horrible, horrible thing that potentially happened. I don't know the ins and outs of the story, so, you know, you go ahead and look that up, but I am definitely going to see Monster Hunter the movie. I'm probably going to see Sonic tomorrow, Jonaas. Oh, I've not yet seen Sonic, and I am very interested. Sonic, don't hit me with your flame.
Oh, you're going to go see Sonic tomorrow? I'm excited for you. Tell me how Jim Carrey looks.
I will. I'll let you know.
Yeah, hopefully he looks awesome.
I heard that he does really well, man. It's like a return to form from, like, early.
Color.
Yeah, early Carrey. It's like I heard that he comes back and does basically the same thing he was doing in the 90s, and it works. I mean, that's what he is. He basically typecasted himself, bro.
But then he tried to, like, be all serious for long.
I mean, Man on the Moon was great. And Truman Show was great.
And what was that other one that was kind of like Butterfly Effect, but not?
21?
23.
23, yeah.
Yeah. I don't remember. Was that good?
I've never seen it, so I couldn't tell you.
He's not a bad, like, serious actor.
He's not a bad actor. Man. He's been doing it for 1,000 years, dude.
You're going to see him one day. We have acting classes under our belt now.
Honestly, Jonaas, I'm going to make this White History Month, and we're going to talk about Jim Carrey, American hero.
Jim Carrey.
I mean, honestly, he's, like, never been in trouble. He's always...
kind of crazy, though, right?
I mean, yeah, he's a little crazy. But, I mean, I think once you've been rich for that long...
you just become crazy?
Yeah, I think that richness drives people crazy.
And it's like, it isn't like a true crazy, it's like an entitlement to the point of, like, you just seem like you're a lunatic, because, like, the world is so different than everybody else to you.
I think it's the fact that people just don't treat you the same. Like, and then you find yourself having to live up to, like, the perception. Like... me or you, it's a surprise. You know, somebody meets us, they're like, I guess this guy's cool. Other people, they're going to have a perception.
Right.
And they're going to expect, like, oh, he's going to say something funny, or he's going to, you know, he's going to act the way that I've heard that he acts from somebody else.
Yeah, I guess. Yeah, it makes sense.
I don't know, man.
That would
That's
be like,
the way I
look
at it.
I don't remember what comedian. Maybe it was Sam Kinison.
Ow.
I don't remember the joke, but it was like he would talk about how, like, he had a reputation as being a partier. So, like, when he would show up and they would, like, bust out, like, coke, they would, like, put out these big giant lines of cocaine, like he's, like, superhuman or something, rather than, like, just, like, doing cocaine like a normal person would, you know, getting a garden hose and, like,
yeah, dude.
And then they're like, he's like, well, I gotta do it because that's my MO, you know.
What?
That's my...
I'm just known for doing coke.
Yeah,
so here we go.
Yeah, like it's...
wait a minute. Where do I get that kind of reputation? I'm kidding.
Like,
I'm kidding. I don't want to be known for that.
Yeah, I don't want to be known for that either.
No.
Yeah, dude, it would just be like, you know, like you're going to show up somewhere and they're just going to bust out a giant D because you're the D guy.
See, yeah, Joe, how do I get known for having orgasms? Because that would be great. Then everybody's like, oh, TNT's coming over. Better get ready to give him an orgasm. That would be great.
I mean...
right?
I guess getting to adult movies.
If we are truly the masters of our own destiny, Jonaas, I require this.
If you want to get to adult movies, like, I'll be your manager.
Jonaas, this has always been a dream of mine, actually, Jonaas.
Will you just show up with your
Yeah, I can show up.
And I'll work out all the other details.
I can show up. I'll be there.
Me being you being my pimp, I'll be your pimp.
I have no problem with that, though. That's the difference between me and you. I'm just not going to give you all of my money. We're going to have a contract, dude.
Yeah,
you got
this. We'll work it out. We'll do it like 80-20.
And believe me, I'm getting a lawyer.
Okay.
Can I don't want to be in the juice, man. This is ridiculous.
Yeah,
you see this?
Yeah, you're in the smoke right now.
This man is after my butthole, dude.
It's
He's after it, dude. You saw it. He was all in my backside. No, I'm not gonna say genitalia. Is your butt really your genitalia? Is that considered genitalia?
I mean, I guess it's close enough, right?
It's close, but it's like, it's not a reproductive organ.
Yeah.
I don't know anybody reproducing out of their butt. No, Jones, don't make a poop joke.
I was not.
You were thinking about not, making dude. A poop joke, dude. I could sense it in your tone of voice. Alright, look, sir. I'm real sick of your business.
You're real sick of my business?
No, I'm talking to the devil. This is Devil Joe, Jones. Savage Devil Joe.
Savage Devil Joe?
Yeah, they call him the Big Red Pickle.
I kind of see that.
Yeah.
Oh, poor guy.
Oh,
too.
Man, don't say I'm stunned. I'm not gonna take it.
Are you fighting with some trash friends?
No, these guys are alright, man. They're attacking. They're not healing me at all, but that's okay. I can't expect them to do it all, dude.
Yeah, I mean, he can. Oh, did he just, did the Big Red Pickle get pickled?
Yeah, it might topple his butt. Now I'm going to smack him in the face.
Toppled his butt, that's what it is.
Smack him in the face with this, and then blop, 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 and then hit him again with one of these, and then smack him again, and then we're going to do this because it's a bad idea.
Do this because it's a bad idea.
Worst decision you ever made, Jonas. Besides getting married. Sorry. You can't set up your own jokes, Dinomight. You got. I know. All right. You can't do that. That's
the worst decision I ever made was. Yeah. I try to make pretty good decisions, man.
I try to say is that I have no regrets.
Yeah, me too. Like,
because even, what was it? What was my quote, Jonas? There's no regrets in life because even a mistake is the gift of strength.
Oh, wow. I never heard you say that, but yes.
I said it in improv, and they asked me something.
I personally feel that we are all fully responsible and accountable for our choices. But even if someone influences us to decide a certain way, we still ultimately have the choice to do it whatever way we want.
So
if you make a bad decision, even if someone else is the influence, it's still your choice and you're still responsible for that decision.
Now, if only you could equate that same thinking to video game shows, maybe you could find inner peace.
Yeah.
It was your word.
I have inner peace.
I mean, I'm not saying it, though. But when you play video games, you clearly have to use your own
head. Oh, I don't have inner peace. I play stuff that you're making mad. Stupid games. Mad maybe. Ugh.
And smack.
What's the worst decision you've ever
made? I don't know, dude. Probably. Like, Oh, man, that's a hard question.
Can going to college be it?
I would say, you know, no, I would not say going
no,
to college.
No, not for you, for me. Can I say that's the worst decision I've ever made?
I would say probably not going to college earlier would probably be the worst decision I ever made, or, you know, like... Like, I'm not looking for, like, something that was, like, life-altering, I guess. By definition, is life-altering if I'd gone to college earlier. But I wish I'd gone to college to be a lawyer.
That's what I always wanted to be when I was a kid.
Yeah, because that was, like, my dream. And now, like, I didn't do that, and I went for something different.
Yeah.
And, like, I do find fulfillment in my work. But,
Yeah, I wonder, since I already have a master's degree, can I just go to law school now?
I would kind of just like the money instead.
Yeah.
Can I just take the cash?
But, like... Can I just go to law school now that I have a graduate degree?
I don't see why not.
I mean, I have to apply, obviously.
I don't see why not. Which one are you under?
I should do that. I could be a law. Yeah. I should go to like go to a really bad law school, but because I can still get a law degree regardless.
It's not.
I go to like just like law lawyer state.
Law lawyer state.
I'm going to law lawyer state
of America. Yeah.
Yeah.
University
of Law Lawyer Bill.
Law Lawyer State U.
Yeah.
Hey. Can I hit you?
Ooh, hit him.
It missed. I'm the bad man. I missed. Oh, but now I'm on the sea, Jonaas. I'm riding him.
Oh, dude, that's awesome.
Yippee-ki-yay, motherfudger.
Why is he not dead yet?
Oh, my God, because he's a big boy.
He's a sponge, dude.
He's a sponge. I mean, yeah, kind of. But he, I don't know. I love the design of
that. Can I give you a hot take on this game?
What's that?
I don't see the point.
You don't see the point?
Yeah, like, well, are you strategizing or are you button mashing?
100% strategizing. I guess you'd have to play to understand. When I say this game is literally like Dark Souls, I mean that it is like
Dark Souls. Looks like you're just button mashing.
No, because every move is choreographed. Like, to do the things that I'm doing take specific button presses.
Oh.
I'm not
just
like
make it look easy because you're a pro.
I mean, basically, like, gotcha. To do this, I have to hold right trigger and press B, and then this is like Y button. But to like get the, man, it's so much more.
You make it look fluid, but it's not.
It 100% is.
Okay.
Like, I would love for you to like even try this game. It looks so simple, but I don't even know how it looks simple because like so much is happening. This thing is like breathing like corrosive mist on the ground that like hurts you while you're in it. I'm jumping around. I'm going right up to his head and trying to smack him in it. He's jumping around. He's smacking me with his teeth, trying to heal. What, like?
Yeah, you're good. I get it.
This game is really good, man, and I'm kind of sad that I came in so late to the party, because it's been out, like I said, since like the 90s, man.
Oh, yeah,
because
they had this game for like PlayStation 1 and 2.
This game has been out for forever.
Dude, you know what I didn't know until yesterday?
That
PlayStation 2 is the top-selling console of all time.
I can see that.
It has like almost 200 million units, and like 4 of the top 5 all-time selling units are PlayStation 1, 2, 3, and 4. The only other one that's in there is the Wii. Like, and the Xbox One's only sold like 46 million units, and that, like, the PS3 sold like 86 million units or something. The PS4 sold 110 million units.
Yeah, but that was a different time, man. Video game consoles were cheaper.
Yeah, but I mean, but even like the new, even like PS3 and PS4, or outselling the Xbox One by a lot.
Yeah. That's for sure. I definitely, when the console war struck, I definitely took the wrong choice.
I was a PlayStation boy up until Xbox 360. I played PlayStation 1,
me
PlayStation
too.
2,
me
and
too.
Then I went Xbox 360 instead.
Yeah, I did that as well. I don't even know why. I think it was just because, like, a lot of my friends were going that route.
Yeah, me too. Well, and I like the controller. But it's the Xbox controller is better for first-person shooters, I think. And that's what I used to play all the time. Anymore, I don't really play anything very much. So, but yeah, I don't know, man. It's all good. Are you gonna go PS5 or Xbox One or Xbox whatever?
I don't know if I can just switch like that, man. I'd have to like talk it over with a bunch of people, make sure they're okay with it.
Be like, is it cool? We ain't gonna play games together no
more. Right. You know how my circle would feel if I just abandoned ship
just
like that?
You just want the PS5 out of nowhere? They'd be like,
oh, stop hitting me. Exactly, man. They'd be heartbroken.
I had a friend who, him and his entire group of friends, switched to PS4 when the Xbox One came out, solely based on the fact that Xbox was going to make all the games discless at first, and then they would backtrack
their games.
And then now they probably don't even buy games to buy them on PS4 anyway.
The Xbox did screw up the Xbox One promo run. That they were talking about, like,
always online.
And,
yeah.
And you know what? You are. You still are always online.
Yeah, you can't even play offline games without being connected to Xbox Live.
Exactly. So they said it, they walked it back, and then they did it, and
nobody
then nobody cared.
So, yeah. It makes me mad, though, because, yeah, but Xbox Live is down. You can't even play games that you don't need internet. It's stupid.
In his mouth. Yeah, just only games that you need the internet for. Oh my God. Come on, guys. I don't want to die here.
Yeah, I don't want to die either.
I don't want to die. We got 10 minutes, man, to kill this thing.
How much health does it have? How can you tell?
You can't. You just keep smacking it, dude. Right now, actually, it's ready to be captured, so I might just try to capture it.
And what's that? Oh. What's the difference?
You can kill it or you can cap it, and we capped it. Big old Devil Joe, sit your pickle butt down, boy.
Oh, how do you capture it?
He's a cutie. That's DAE, but you set a trap, and then you use some sleep pellets. So on the next episode.
Oh, okay. That is all the time we have for today's episode. Please make sure to like and subscribe. If you've already done that, tell Grandma we love her. Tell her to come see us.
Mm-hmm.
Look for Jonaas.
TNT Dinomight.
Catch you on the next one. We are out.